said it. You just have to believe it and accept it.
Dr. Anthony L. Trice, dedicated to sound teaching, strong training, leadership, and development. Prayers are being answered and testimonies all around the world, helping change one life at a time. Find out how to be a partner with Anthony Trice Ministerial Network. And thank you for tuning in for today's message.
Heaven and earth shall pass away.
You know, heaven and earth gonna pass away. This world gonna pass away.
But my words shall not pass away.
But my words shall not pass away.
But of that day and that hour knoweth no man.
This is my foundational scripture. That day and hour no man know. Read.
No, not the angels which are in heaven.
Even the angels that's rejoicing, that spend time with Jesus, they don't even know. Mm-hmm. Read.
Neither the Son.
Neither Jesus don't even know.
But the Father.
Only the Father, only God know. So the Father, Son is God. Only one know is Jesus. Only one know is God. Jesus don't know, the angels don't know. Read.
Take ye heed.
Take you heed. That means pay attention what you're doing. Quit walking around on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter, walking down the street on your cell phone, and ain't paying attention what you're doing. You say, take heed. When my son going to school on the bus stop in the morning, I tell him, take the earphones out of your ear so you can hear your surroundings, so you can see what's going on, so you can hear what's going on. The Bible says, take heed. We need to take heed. Y'all see what's going on in the world. He said, on us to take heed, read.
And watch.
The Bible says watch as well as pray. We need to be watching and we need to be praying. And this is different with being afraid. Watching means just to watch your location, watch your surroundings, watch the people you with. We need to be praying. We need to be praying for other people. We need to be listening while we're praying. The Bible says watch as well as pray. Men, watch these young men. You don't know these dudes. These guys will kill you. Tell you they're your friends, but they'll kill you. Women, don't be around these men. These men will put a drink in your, or some in your drink. Watch yourself. The Bible says watch as well as pray. Read.
For none of us know when the time is.
We don't know when the time is. We don't know when Jesus is coming back. But he's telling us to watch and pray. That word watch means to take position, to be on guard. You need to be on your position.
Right.
You need to be on guard. Some of y'all got off your position.
Uh-huh.
You don't come to church no more.
Uh-huh.
You don't read the word of God no more.
Yeah.
You don't pray no more. You don't see God no more. You out of position.
Yeah.
Just because you out of position don't mean you can't get back into position.
Right.
Read.
For the Son of Man is as a man taking a far journey and to left his house.
Jesus been gone for 2,000 years ago. He took a journey. So he put us down here to rule and dominate the earth, read.
And gave authority to his servants.
We his servants, we should have authority over the devil.
Yeah.
The devil should have authority over us.
Right.
We should come against the spirit of depression.
Yeah.
We should come against the spirit of suicide.
Right.
What a power, what a authority.
Yeah.
We need to cast out demons.
Uh-huh.
We need to pull down strongholds.
Yeah.
We need to come against jealousy.
Uh-huh.
We need to come against perversion.
Yeah.
We need to bind that spirit of murder. We need to bind that spirit of racism.
Yeah.
God gave us authority, read.
And to every man his work.
His work. You should be doing some work down here. Usher, greeter, singer, praise team, whatever. You need to be doing something down here.
Yeah.
Read.
And commanded the porter to watch.
And man the man at the door to watch. How many of you know when you go to the bank, the guard, he should be lollygagging. He should be up there with the bank teller playing the joker. His position, he should be on the position. Why should he be on the position? Because a thief or a robber might come in. So he needs to be on his guard. You need to be on your guard. Read.
Watch ye, therefore.
The Bible keeps saying watch.
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 Y'all see the signs of the time?
Yeah.
One day it's cold, one day it's hot.
Yeah. Watch.
You gotta watch.
Yeah.
Read.
For you know not when the master of the house will
come. You don't know when Jesus is coming back?
Shoulder.
You don't know when Jesus is coming back? Or you gonna be ready?
Right.
The Bible said watch as well as pray. Read.
If he will come at evening.
He might come at 7 o'clock this evening.
Right.
When you get out of church.
Right.
Read.
Or at midnight.
Or at midnight while you sleep.
Uh-huh.
Or while you get your freak on.
Right.
Crowing.
When a cock crow, when it's early, read.
Or in
relationship with him. Don't let them find you sleeping. I remember I used to be in the streets. They'd be like, man, don't let them dudes catch you slipping. Because they'll get on your head. Don't let Jesus keep you slipping, because he'll get on your head. Read.
Watch, I say unto you, and watch, I say unto all.
Watch.
Watch.
God say, keep on watching.
Watch.
Because you don't know the day, or you don't know the hour. Amen. But you got to stay in position. You got to stay on your going. How do you stay in position? You keep reading the word of God. You keep praying. You keep worshiping. Amen. Because if you don't, stuff going to get stale in your life. A lot of us are stuck because we won't change our position. Y'all didn't hear me. Y'all didn't hear me. You got to get in a position to be blessed. You can pray all day for money, but you ain't gonna get no money until you give money. The Bible say give. See, you praying to get your credit together, but if you don't start paying your bills on time, your credit ain't gonna get together. Y'all don't hear me. See, y'all want God to do something. He already did it 2,000 years ago. You want to get married? Woman, lady, you want to get married? Okay, get your nails done. Get in position. Quit walking around looking angry all the time. Maybe he'll speak to you. Go get your hair fixed. Put on some makeup. Put on some smell good. But see, you got to get in position.
Second Chronicles, chapter 20, verse 13 to 18. Say, I gotta be in position
to be blessed.
Me and my wife, we was talking, and she's a consultant, and they be hiring people that's qualified, but they can't handle the position. See, when you can handle a position, you can handle the pressure that comes with the position. See, everybody can't handle the position. Okay, check this out. I'm in this position. When I met my wife, I gotta still love her. But if I'm in this position, I could be mad at my wife all day long. When I'm in this position, I gotta give more money than what you gotta give. When you in this position, you ain't gotta give at all. When I'm mad at my kids, in this position, I still gotta love them. When you in this position, you don't have to. When my head hurt and my neck hurt, I'm a minister. I still gotta be in this position. In this position, I ain't gotta come to church because my neck hurt.
all of them in position. If they're out of position, they're going to miss the ball. As a wide receiver, you got to run to the right spot. If you ain't in the right spot, you ain't going to score no touchdown. But see, if the defender in the right spot, he going to get an interception. It's up to you to make a move and get in the right spot. Respect my position. You might not like me. You don't care for me. Respect me. Because I'm in position.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hey, amen. Let's go to 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 13 and 18. Sorry, I mean to get wild about this.
It's all right.
This is the story about Jehoshaphat, and he's going to go up against the army, and he got afraid, he got scared, because he seen a big army coming up against his small army, so he didn't know what to do, so he started praying to God. So let's go to verse 13, read, Sister Adams.
Now all of Judah stood before the Lord.
All of Judah stood before the Lord.
With their little ones.
With their little ones.
With their wives and their children.
You know what Judah means? Praise. So the wives and the children, the whole house were praising God. Read.
Then upon Jehiel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jael, the son of Matanah, a Levite of the sons of Asaph, came the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation.
While they was praising God, while they were worshiping God, the Spirit came up on Jehiel. Read.
And he said, hearken ye, all Judah.
He said, hearken. Listen now. We've been praising that. Now listen to the word of God now. Read.
And ye inhabitants of Jerusalem.
Jerusalem means with worship. Read.
And thou King Jehoshaphat.
Read.
Thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid.
Stop being afraid. Mm-hmm. God said, I haven't given you the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. Quit being afraid. So much too afraid. Read.
Nor dismayed.
No dismay. Don't be discouraged. Read.
By reason of this great multitude.
By this multitude. Quit looking at your circumstances. Yeah. Just because the bill's piled up, don't get afraid. Just because the landlord ready to put you out, don't get afraid. Just because you see sickness in your body, stop being afraid. That's just the devil messing with your mind. Read.
For the battle is not yours.
God said the battle ain't yours. Read.
It's God's.
It's God's. Read.
Tomorrow, go ye down against them.
Tomorrow, go to the Social Security office and go get your money. Tomorrow, go to the bank and go get your car. Tomorrow, go down and get your house tomorrow. God said, go down tomorrow. Whatever you decide to get, go get your inheritance. Read.
Behold.
He said, behold.
They come up by the cliff of Zin.
But when they don't come up against you, though. Your enemies gonna come up against you. When you go to get your stuff, the devil gonna rise up against you. So you need to be ready. Read.
And ye shall find them at the end of the brook.
He said, you're gonna find them at the end of the brook.
Before the wilderness of Jeruel.
Before the wilderness of Jeruel. Read.
Ye shall not need to fight.
Quit fighting with your fists.
Come on.
When somebody talking about the quit talking about them back. When they jealous of you, love them. Quit fighting with them. tomorrow to go out and get what you're gonna get from God. Go get your car. Go get your house. Go get it. Read.
And know that the Lord will be with you.
And God will be with you. But how are you gonna know if you don't know? Get that promotion. You got to be in this position to get it though. Don't say you want a promotion and you late for work all the time. You got a bad attitude. Don't go apply for that position. You make sure you right before you go and get that position.
Amen.
Say, I need to be in a position.
To be blessed.
Amen. Let's go to Mark chapter 2, verse 1 through 5. And this is a little short story. And we got to be in position. Young folks, get in position. You got a job, save you some money right now. So if you 18, 19 years old, by the time you get 30 or 40, you almost got $10,000 in the bank.
Uh-huh.
If you want to go on a trip, get a position.
Uh-huh.
Save you some money right now. So next year, you're going to have the money, so it won't be a struggle for you. See, we got to be wise, too.
That's right.
Amen. Man, my wife, we was talking, and our kids, they go to camp when school's out, and it costs a lot of money. So me and my wife, we said, no, we're going to do? We're going to start putting some money up so we can be in position.
Uh-huh.
See, God ain't finna do everything.
Amen.
You wanna keep your marriage hot? Quit going into bed with some pajamas on. With a scarf on your head. Man, quit coming to bed with some raggedy socks on and a raggedy t-shirt on. You see, we don't wanna get in a position. Be blessed. Yeah. From the crowns of my head to the sole of my feet.
he entered into Capernaum after some days, and it was noised that he was in the house.
Now it was again that Jesus entered Capernaum after some days. It was noised that he entered the house. So the people came to see Jesus, read.
And straightway many were gathered together.
Man, it was many people gathered together. And every time I read these stories, it'll always be a multitude of crowd. You know why? Because they want to see something. They want to see something. People want to see something. Man, when I go to work, the guy came up to me, man, how many cars you got? That's what he said, how many cars you got? I said, well, I got 3 cars. He said, man, you doing it? I said, no, I'm Jesus doing it.
That there was no room to receive.
It was so crowded. It was no room. It wasn't enough room. And it's going to be a lot of enough room here. We keep declaring, saying, people who stand in the line to get in our church. Coming in for life, it'll be an overflow. You know why? Because there's a tragedy that's going on in the world today. When them people got shot in Orlando, the homosexuals, lesbians, they should start coming into the church. When people start getting everywhere, terrorism going on, people gonna start coming to church. So God gotta cause a tragedy to bring people in. Amen.
Not so much as about the door, and he preached the word unto them.
As long as you preaching the word, people gonna come and receive what the word of God is saying to me.
And they come unto him, bringing one sick of the palsy.
This man had sick of palsy, he was paralyzed. Read.
Which was born of 4.
And it was 4 men that was carrying him. He was sick. He was paralyzed. He couldn't move. Read.
And when they could not come nigh unto him for the press, they uncovered the roof where he was.
Said somebody take the roof off this. And when they could get to the crowd, it was so crowded, they climbed on top of the roof. Him and his friend had, they climbed on top of the roof. Read.
And when they had broken the roof up, they let down the bed wherein the sick of the palsy lay.
They got a physician. They took the roof off. Yeah. They broke it down with their burden. Yeah. They got a physician. Yeah. See, they had to do something. They didn't just call on Jesus to pray. They got a physician for this man that can be blessed. Yeah. Read.
Now when Jesus saw their faith.
Jesus saw their faith.
Yeah. Read. He said unto the sick of the palsy, son, thy sins have been forgiven.
He said, son, your sins have forgiven me. And I was reading back in those days, the roof had a flat top. Yeah. Uh-huh. And it had outside here a staircase up there. And the roof was often made a thick layer of clay, packed with stones, rollers, supported by mats and branches across the beams. They dug an opening in the roof with their bare hands. They did all this just to get a position to see Jesus. What position you getting yourself into? The reason why some of us paralyzed, because we got sin in our heart. The reason why Jesus didn't say, take up your mat and walk, he said your sins are forgiven, because he know he had sin in his heart. And when he had sins in his heart, he was paralyzed.
Dr. Anthony L. Trice is determined to take the gospel around the world to a people that are hurting mentally, physically, and financially. Your prosperity is in your seed. God has shown him how to be prosperous, successful, and with integrity. Ecclesiastes 10 and 19, money answered all things. We would like you to partner with us. Help us spread the word of God. Sign up as a monthly partner today and take advantage of this special offer. For a love token of $30 plus shipping and handling, you will receive this prosperity package, which includes Your Prosperity Is in Your Seed, a powerful teaching CD, and prosperity oil. All partners will receive a monthly CD, newsletter, and much, much more. For more information, call 314-659-8522 or visit us online at www.anthonytrice.org. You can write to us at 7200 West Forest, St. Louis, Missouri, 63136. And we thank you for your support.
Hey, that was a powerful, awesome word from the Lord. I would like to thank you for tuning into our television broadcast on today. God is doing some awesome things here in this ministry. Our members are being delivered. They're being healed. They're experiencing financial breakthrough. And I want you to experience that same anointing that's on this ministry in your life by partnering with me here at Anthony Trice Ministry. You can go to my website at anthonytrice.org and become a monthly partner. God bless you.
Thank you for watching today's broadcast. If ever in St. Louis area, please come visit Covenant for Life Christian Center at 7200 West Forest, St. Louis, Missouri, 63136. Or give us a call at 314-659-8522. For more information on how to get connected, write to us or visit us online at anthonytrice.org. And we thank you for your continued support.